Hey, what's going on, Charlotte Assembly of God? Welcome to day two of our 21 days of prayer and fasting. We're just going to wait a minute or two for people to hop on. Hey, when you hop on, just say hello, give us a heart emoji, maybe some lifted hands. Just let us know you're here with us. It's good to see you guys tonight. Hope you guys are having an incredible time of prayer and fasting. Just wait a few more minutes, hopping on, not minutes, probably seconds. Hey guys, good evening, it's good to see everyone. Love you guys, love seeing all the names scroll across. Hey, today is our second day of 21 days of prayer and fasting. And typically as a church, we carve out the beginning of the year for a time of prayer and fasting. And what our habit has been is to do 7 days. And with all of the things that have happened in 2020, and we just really felt in our heart, hey, this is a good time. This is a good year. This is a great opportunity to not just pray for and fast for 7 days, but we're going to pray and fast for 21 days. And so I'm just encouraged by what God is already doing in my life and in our church. And so I trust that you are praying and putting extra attention and focus on Jesus. And God is going to really work and move in your life these next few weeks. So this is what I know. If you seek him, if you go after him, God is going to show up in an incredible way. And so we are going through Psalms 25, my favorite Psalms in the whole world. Psalms 25 as a church, and every night at 8 p.m., we're hopping on to pray together and to look at the theme for the day. And so today, day two, and we have Psalms 25:2, and every night at 8 p.m., there's going to be a different person or couple from the church that's going to give the devotion. And the way we're doing it is the SOAP method. So we're going to give a scripture, an observation, application, and then we're going to pray with you. And so tonight, for night two of our prayer and fasting, I've got Amelia Grace here, and she's going to give us the devotion for tonight. So you got it.
Okay, so today's verse is Psalms 25:2. Oh my God, in you I trust. Let me not be put to shame. Let not my enemies exalt me. So when David's writing this verse, his life is at stake. But when David's saying this, he's praying to God and saying that, I have complete trust in you. He's saying that he has confidence in Jesus and that he will answer his prayer. And he knows that Jesus hears him and he knows that Jesus is with him. And the second verse is 1 John 5:14. This confidence we have in approaching God, that if we ask anything according to his will, it will happen. What this is saying is that we know that we can approach Jesus, and we can approach Jesus in full confidence because we know who he is and we know what he does and what he did for us. He laid his life down for us so that we could live. And he is forgiving and encouraging and always with us. And God is never changing. He is always faithful. The God that we serve today is the same God who laid down his life and let his son go to the cross for you. And we have a confidence that in who he is that's unshakable because we know that Jesus is there for us. So I'm going to close out in prayer. Lord Jesus, I pray that you would be with CAG, Lord, and I pray that you would help them have confidence in you and who you are. I pray that they would feel fulfilled during this fast and that they would just be able to come to you in confidence because of who we are. We thank you for who you are and what you're doing for us. Amen.
Amen. Well, hey, CAG, let me hop in there. Great job, Amelia Grace. Love it. Hey, we have confidence in who God is, and we have confidence that God hears us. And so as you pray and as you fast and you commit these next 3 weeks to really seeking after the Lord and putting your focus and your heart on him, you can do so with the confidence because his word says that he hears us and he answers us. And so we have confidence in God's promises. We have confidence in God's character. And we have confidence in God's provision, confidence in God's purposes, confidence in God's protection for our life. And so as you pray and as you fast and as we go after the Lord together as a church, we're doing so because we have confidence in what God can do in us and through us. And so we love you. God bless you. And may you have an incredible night. We'll see you tomorrow night, 8 p.m. For Psalms 25:3. And I have no idea who's bringing the devotion. So join us and we'll find out together. We love you guys. Take care.